welcome to the Film Nerds Film Quiz Volume 2. I am your host, Emily Slade, host of the Why This Film podcast, and I bring you quizzes that are a little bit different from your average pub quiz. This week, it's another film special. It's going to be hard. That's your warning before you start throwing your pen across the room. You will need a pen and paper to write down your answers. There will be three rounds and then the answers, and then another three rounds and then the answers. There will be picture and audio rounds, so make sure to pay attention. Are you sitting comfortably? Then we'll begin. Round one is Metropolis to Moonlight. Metropolis to Moonlight takes us from the 1920s all the way through to the 2010s. There is a film question for each decade. Let's go.
Number one. Name the 1925 epic adventure drama movie that was a remake of a 1907 15-minute short and was later remade again in 1959, starring Charlton Heston. Number two. Which 1932 pre-code controversial horror film was banned in Britain but later found acclaim in the mid-20th century for its depiction of people with disabilities? Number three. Which 1942 movie gave us the jump scare technique known as the Luton Bus? In the Muppets' Most Wanted song, We're Doing a Sequel, which 1957 film does the Swedish chef suggest as a film about the existential conundrum of religious faith, to which Kermit replies, "I don't think Americans read subtitles." Number five. Nominated in 10 categories, which 1965 epic romantic drama starring Julie Christie won 5 Oscars, but lost Best Picture and Best Director to The Sound of Music? Number six. Which 1977 film has the second biggest selling soundtrack of all time? Number seven. Socrates, Billy the Kid, Sigmund Freud, and Joan of Arc appear in which 1989 movie? Number eight. Which 1998 movie's 23-minute opening scene at $12 million cost 20% of the budget on only 14% of the movie? Number nine. Name the 2006 dystopian action thriller that takes place in 2027, starring Clive Owen, Julianna Moore, and Michael Caine. And number 10. Which 2015 Yorgos Lanthimos movie has the characters Short-Sighted Woman, Hotel Manager, and Loner Leader?
Round 2 Round two is swipe right for a bad time. You're going to hear some Tinder profiles from some of the most notorious people in film. I'm looking for the name of the character and the film that they are from.
Number one. Love my mother to death. Big fan of taxidermy. Enjoys short showers. Number two. Has two daughters and a beautiful stone collection. Huge activist for world peace. Number three. Will steal your girlfriend and your boss and your girlfriend's gross ex-boyfriend. And by steal, I mean eat. Not from around here. Number four. Family is everything. Big into skincare. Looking for a job in a hardware store. Number five. Loves moonlit boat rides to my underground lair and candles. Can write you an aria in like 5 minutes. Number six. Literal eighth wonder of the world. Visited New York once, didn't care for it. Number seven. Big fan of a midnight snack. Favorite time of year has to be Christmas. Number eight, always ready for dinner, loves children and napping. Number nine, love my family, proud proprietor of the Museum of Monsters and Mad Men. Number 10. Civil engineer, loves puzzles.
Round three, be our guest. It's an audio round. You're going to hear clips from movie scenes at the dinner table. You need to tell me which movie this dinner scene is from.
What's that?
Sushi.
Sushi?
Rice, raw fish, and seaweed.
You won't accept a guy's tongue in your mouth and you're gonna eat that?
Can I eat?
What's that?
Sushi.
Sushi?
Rice, raw fish, and seaweed.
You won't accept a guy's tongue in your mouth and you're gonna eat that?
Can I eat?
Be my guest.
I gotta know what a $5 shake tastes like.
You can use my straw. I don't have cooties.
Yeah, but maybe I do.
Cooties I can handle. Be my guest.
I gotta know what a $5 shake tastes like.
You can use my straw. I don't have cooties.
Yeah, but maybe I do.
Cooties I can handle.
And the first thing that I'm going to do when I get back is to get some decent food.
I don't want to talk about what it's made of. I'm eating this. What's the matter? The food ain't that bad, baby.
First thing that I'm going to do when I get back is to get some decent food.
I don't want to talk about what it's made of. I'm eating this. What's the matter? The food ain't that bad, baby.
I can't remember the last time I asked a waiter to give my compliments to the chef. And now I find myself in the extraordinary position of having my waiter be the chef.
Thanks, but...
I can't remember the last time I asked a waiter to give my compliments to the chef. And now I find myself in the extraordinary position of having my waiter be the chef.
Thanks, but...
Must show you this. Lickable wallpaper for nursery walls.
Lick an orange. It tastes like an orange. Lick a pineapple. It tastes like a pineapple. Go ahead, try it.
Oh. Mmm, I got a plum.
Must show you this. Lickable wallpaper for nursery walls.
Lick an orange. It tastes like an orange. Lick a pineapple. It tastes like a pineapple. Go ahead, try it.
Oh. Mmm, I got a plum.
Here. Now here's the sack that contains the brain.
I would really like some water.
That smells great.
Here. Now here's the sack that contains the brain.
I would really like some water.
That smells great.
I feel like I've been touched by an angel.
And look, just what we ordered. I'm a little scared about all of this.
Me too.
You think we shouldn't eat it?
I'm not that scared.
I feel like I've been touched by an angel. And look, just what we ordered. I'm a little scared about all of this.
Me too.
You think we shouldn't eat it?
I'm not that scared.
You see, you start out with a little bit of oil, and you fry some garlic. Then you throw in some tomatoes, tomato paste, you fry it, you make sure it doesn't stick. Mm-hmm. You get it to a boil, you shove in all your sausage and your meatballs. You see, you start out with a little bit of oil, and you fry some garlic. Then you throw in some tomatoes, tomato paste, you fry it, you make sure it doesn't stick. Mm-hmm. You get it to a boil, you shove in all your sausage and your meatballs.
I hear Sir Edmund Hillary's planning an attempt on the South Pole. By tractor. Have some more beans, Mrs. Matheson.
I'll have a few of those, lad.
I really think we should be going in here. Thank you, Lionel.
What? No pudding?
I hear Sir Edmund Hillary's planning an attempt on the South Pole. By tractor. Have some more beans, Mrs. Matheson.
I'll have a few of those, lad.
I really think we should be going in here. Thank you, Lionel.
What? No pudding.
It's cute, Delia.
The end of the first half. Time for some answers. Number one, the 1925 epic adventure drama was Ben-Hur. Number two, the 1932 controversial horror film was Freaks. Number three, the Luton bus comes from Cat People. Number four, the Swedish chef suggested The Seventh Seal. Number 5, the 1965 epic romantic drama was Dr. Zhivago. Number 6, the second biggest selling soundtrack of all time, is Saturday Night Fever. Number 7, Socrates, Billy the Kid, Sigmund Freud and Joan of Arc are all in Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Number 8, that 23-minute opening scene is from Saving Private Ryan. Number 9, the 2006 dystopian action thriller was Children of Men. And number 10, Short-Sighted Woman, Hotel Manager and Loner Leader can all be found in The Lobster. Number 1. Loves His Mother, that was Norman Bates from Psycho. Number 2, that beautiful stone collection, that's Thanos from the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Number 3, he's not from around here, it's Audrey 2 from Little Shop of Horrors. Number 4, good with skin, it's Leatherface from Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Number 5, he loves candles, it's the Phantom of the Opera from the Phantom of the Opera. Number 6, the 8th wonder of the world is King Kong from King Kong. Number 7, they love Christmas, it's the Gremlins from Gremlins. Number 8, he loves children, it's the Pale Man from Pan's Labyrinth. Number 9, the Museum of Monsters and Mad Men belongs to Captain Spaulding from House of 1000 Corpses and the Devil's Rejects. And number 10, the civil engineer who loves puzzles was Jigsaw from Saw. Number 1 was The Breakfast Club. Number 2 was Pulp Fiction. Number 3 was Alien. Number 4 was Ratatouille. Number 5 was Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Number 6 was Hannibal. Number 7 was A Little Princess. Number 8 was The Godfather. Number 9 was Brain Dead. And number 10 was Beetlejuice.
And we're back! How did you do? No need to worry. Anything could happen in the next 3 rounds. Round 4 is quick! Check IMDb! You're going to see 3 pictures from 3 different movies with one thing in common. An actor. I'm looking for the name of the actor or actress that appears in all 3 movies pictured. Don't actually check IMDb.
Round 5, all good things come in threes. It's a trilogy round.
Number 1. A French anti-tragedy, Polish anti-comedy, and French anti-romance that culminate in a linked ferry accident make up what trilogy? Number 2. In which trilogy could you attend the Enchantment Under the Sea dance twice? Number 2. In which trilogy could you attend the Enchantment Under the Sea dance twice? Number 4. Which trilogy is based off award-winning Swedish crime novels published posthumously in 2005 after the author suddenly died of a heart attack in 2004? Number 5. Which trilogy follows lovers Jesse and Celine at three different parts of their lives in 1995, 2004, and 2013? Number 6. Which reboot trilogy starting in 2011 stars Andy Serkis in a primary motion capture role? Number 7. Name the supernatural superhero trilogy about Marvel Comics character Eric Brooks. Number 8. Which trilogy was responsible for introducing the Employment Relations Film Production Work Amendment Act 2010 as part of a deal between Warner Brothers and government ministers to keep the film production in New Zealand? Number 9. Directed by Park Chan-wook, which trilogy, whilst not narratively connected, was dubbed such by international critics due to the thematic links of revenge, ethics, violence, and salvation? And number 10. Name the Italian film trilogy, also known as the Man with No Name trilogy or the Blood Money trilogy, that established a genre.
And finally, round 6 is WIF. Women in film, in front and behind the camera. How well do you know the ladies of the industry that are pushing boundaries, scooping up awards, and breaking glass ceilings?
Number 1. Which costume designer often collaborates with Tim Burton? Number 2. What was the first female superhero feature film? Number 3. Which actress was paid 8 times less than her co-star Mark Wahlberg for the film All the Money in the World? Number 4. Which poet, singer, memoirist, and activist's directorial debut was down in Delta. Number 5. Who was the screenwriter for Juno and Jennifer's Body? Number 6. Which actress finished her 2018 acceptance speech with the words Inclusion Rider? Number 7. Who became the first black woman to win the directing award in the US dramatic competition at the 2012 Sundance Film Festival? Number 8. How many women have been nominated for Best Director? Bonus point if you can name them all. Number 9. Rachel Morrison became the first female cinematographer nominated for an Academy Award, but which Marvel Cinematic Universe movie did she work on? And number 10. As of July 2019, Empire Magazine's top 100 film characters had 10 women in it. Only 2 of those 10 never hold a weapon. Can you name me 3 out of those 10 women?
That's all the rounds complete. Time for some answers. Number 1, that was the Three Colors trilogy. Number 2, The Enchantment Under the Sea Dance, is in the Back to the Future trilogy. Number 3, Within the Woods, became the Evil Dead trilogy. Number 4, those Swedish crime novels, became The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, or the Millennium trilogy. Number 5, Jesse and Celine are in the Before trilogy. Number 6, Andy Serkis is the main character in the Planet of the Apes trilogy. Number 7, Eric Brooks, that's the Blade trilogy. Number 8, fighting to keep the film production in New Zealand, was the Hobbit trilogy. Number 9, Park Chan-wook directed the Vengeance trilogy. And number 10, the Western genre was established by the Dollars trilogy. Number 1, the costume designer was Colleen Atwood. Number 2, the first female superhero film was Supergirl in 1984.
Number 3, Michelle Williams was paid 8 times less than Mark Wahlberg. Number 4, Down in Delta was the directorial debut for Maya Angelou. Number 5, Diablo Cody wrote the screenplay for Juno and Jennifer's Body. Number 6, Frances McDormand finished her 2018 acceptance speech with Inclusion Rider. Number 7, it was Ava DuVernay who was the first black woman to win the directing award at the 2012 Sundance Film Festival. Number 8, 5 women have been nominated for Best Director at the Academy Awards. In 2017, it was Greta Gerwig with Lady Bird. In 2009, it was Catherine Bigelow with The Hurt Locker. 2003 was Sofia Coppola with Lost in Translation. 1993 was Jane Campion with The Piano. And 1976 was Lena Wertmüller with Seven Beauties. Number 9, Rachel Morrison worked on Black Panther. And number 10, you could have had Edna Mode from The Incredibles, Wednesday Addams from The Addams Family, Lisbeth Salander from Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, Marge Gunderson from Fargo, Sarah Connor from Terminator, Katniss Everdeen from The Hunger Games, Amélie Poulain from Amélie, Amy Dunn from Gone Girl, The Bride from Kill Bill, or Ellen Ripley from Alien.
There you have it. That was the Film Nerds Film Quiz Volume 2. There's plenty more on their way to YouTube. Make sure in the meantime to check out Why This Film Podcast, a podcast that looks back on the movies of your childhood. It can be found across all podcasting platforms, and episodes come out every Tuesday. Let me know how you did. Post your scores in the comments below. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe.